camber plate install. This will be going on my 240Z, but hopefully these principles apply to other cars and weld in camber plates. This is one way to do it. I'm trying to make sure everything's in check. We got all the angles right, it's positioned right, it's not cockeyed. It's so easy just to draw it, cut it, and slap it in, but I think it's super important to get the angles right on this thing and put them in correctly, because if you don't, you're going to be in a world of hurt trying to do it again. So let me explain what we have going on here. So here we are. I have my nice shiny new coilovers, but these can't be installed unless this camber plate is attached to it. Therefore, I will be putting these camber plates in my car. You can see this is a thick gauge raw steel piece. So what we're gonna do is take that shape and cut it out of here. As you can see, the first step is going to be to strip the paint off this guy and then remove this upper reinforcement piece, as well as remove this bump here, if you will, and that'll allow us to layer new camber plates on there and get measurements of angles and such. And then from there, we'll be able to cut our hole, drop our camber plate in, weld it up, and we'll be done. So this shouldn't be too terrible. I've already removed the interior and cloth pieces. Like, eventually we'll go back and we'll coat it with paint and things like that. This will allow us to get the coilovers on the car and put it on the ground. So
let's do this.
First step, safety glasses. Do not skimp out on this. Another thing you'll want is ear protection. These things make a world of difference when it comes to grinding and doing loud things in the garage. You won't believe how much different the experience is. Not just like noise, but just like overall experience. It's just so much calmer and more manageable. Pick yourself up some of these over-ear ones. These are the best. Time to grind off all the paint and seam sealer from the top of the strut tower. Okay, we have the first one cleaned off pretty well. As you can see, this is kind of a reinforcement plate, is what I call it, that will cut off, and that'll expose this spare tower, and then we can pull our measurements off that. This isn't really a good surface measuring the angle of the new plate, just because it's kind of a rough piece, and based on some other people's measurements, it's not consistent with both sides, so we'll avoid measuring there, and we'll take it off and measure at the base. Time for number two. Here we go. Here we go, bare strut towers. And next step is to cut this guy off. Let's grab our 3-inch cutoff wheel. So basically, this can get a little tedious, but we want to take this and cut that weld as close as we can off of there without actually cutting through the base of the tower there. So you just kind of got to use your judgment, like I said, without disturbing the actual base that we want to use to measure our angle. We just need to break the weld and break this piece off. It might just take some of the weld probably will stick there, and we'll have to take some pliers or something and take it off too. Turns out the little new 3-inch cutoff wheel on air is weak. It's hella weak, so I'm breaking out the heavy artillery. This is always fun, making these little cuts. We'll be right back.
I freaking hate you!
Sorry, had a moment there. It is off, and I will definitely be using my electric grinder this time around, but hopefully I have enough wheel left, because you see, after you use this for a while, the wheel gets smaller and smaller. So let's check and see if I have a wheel. And yes, we have wheels. We have wheels for days. Let's go. You see, I went a little too deep there. It's not the lever I wanted to open up. Fix that. I accidentally cut through the whole tower. Not a huge deal, but I'm making a couple of cuts here just to break the damn thing up. See if that helps. Got a little area here that decided to stick around. I'm cutting this off anyway. Just making me work for it. Oh, unfortunately, as you can see, I cut a little too much. It's a little too deep here. So I'm gonna put that back into position where it was roughly. Cut the center piece out. And we'll be ready to start measuring. Next part of the process is to level the car this way horizontally. As you can see, I'm about 1.4 degrees too low on the right side. So in order to fix that, I needed to pick up the right side of the car and either shim the jack stand or go up a notch on the jack stand. I'm thinking I'm gonna have to shim it because just going up a click on the jack stand is pretty significant jump. So let's do that. I've adjusted the right jack stand and we're at 0.1 right here, measuring off of the rear deck lid mounting surface. Depending where you measure, I'm sure that's pretty close within tolerance. So let's measure the angle on the other, on the strut towers. So I got to level back out. I set my new camber plates on here. Sorry, it's a little messy. That one's not set, but be careful with these little tabs here on the edges here from the body. That can kind of throw off your angle. But as I put this one on, I'm showing 18.2 degrees, 18.2, 18.3 on the right. So you want to write that down, and you want to mimic that angle when you put this camber plate in there. Camber plate sitting pretty flat here, pretty comfortable with that. And we have a measurement of 17.5 on the left, 17.4, 17.5. So write that down. Along with the X angle, you want to make a note of the Y angle.
So you want to set it across something like this. And I'm getting on mine 2.3. So write that down as well.
So at this stage, I'm using a string to determine if my camber plates are in line with one another. Basically, I have these two white lines. And as I'm looking directly down on it, I'm making sure the white line, the string resides on top of the white line, and I need to go over to this side, and if it lined up relative to each other, all four white lines will line up. Of course, this is dependent on where you're placing the string, which also needs to be measured.
we're doing is fitting this camber plate a little better in here. As you can see, it doesn't, I can kind of force it in there, but it doesn't quite sit in there like I want. And there's this gap here, I don't know if you can see that, but basically this, you clean out this corner, I believe. That was all it really needed, was a little cleaning out in that corner, and now it's almost loose. But, and just for the record, I didn't make perfect cuts, and this thing doesn't just, you know, slot in there. If I let go, it'll fall out. But we will grab my magnet and start filling it. I think I went with this one. Yeah, about 11 gauge. This one's a little too small. 11 gauge, 030 solid core wire, 3 and a 40. So we got a 3 on the wired feed and a 40 on the speed. Okay, as we can see, I had a 17.5 on the left. 17.5, 17.4, front to back, 2.5, 2.6. Okay, there we go.
Anyway, on to the next one. So, as far as installing the camber plate, we're done. You know, everything lined up, we got the angles in there right. You know, I'm happy with how it turned out for the most part. My welds could be a little bit prettier, but what can you do? We're moving on to dropping the actual suspension on like we originally wanted. But now that we got our camber plates in, we can bolt up the struts to the tops. Away we go. So, if you like these kinds of videos, hit the subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.